Exposition time. I recorded this whole thing and then I realized that my voice sounded really nasally and terrible, and I could probably make it not sound that way, but I'm getting over a cold, and that would be tedious, and I don't want to shoot it again. Sorry. Anyway! This movie is absolutely fantastic. So, Arrival is the new film directed by Denis Villeneuve, who also directed Prisoners, Sicario, and Enemy. It stars Amy Adams, Jeremy Renner, Forest Whitaker, and some guy who kind of looks like Joaquin Phoenix, but he isn't Joaquin Phoenix. This film is about Amy Adams, who plays Dr. Louise Banks, who is like, number one linguist in the world, and aliens come to Earth. And there's like 12 different pods all over the planet. So Forrest Whitaker and his military crew track her down, team her up with Jeremy Renner, the scientist, and they send them in to try to communicate with the aliens because she's number one linguist and she could crack the crazy code of alien language, apparently, and figure out why they're here. And that's basically it. That's the setup to the movie. So everything in this movie was pretty much right on time with how it should have been, if that makes any sense. The acting was perfect, for lack of a better word. I'd go as far to say that this is the strongest performance I've seen out of Amy Adams, and that's a really big compliment because I'm talking about a career that is literally littered with strong performances. And Jeremy Renner and Forest Whitaker were both great. They added a lot to the film with not taking any away from the focus of Amy because this is really her movie. I didn't like that Joaquin wannabe though, but I suppose I wasn't supposed to. So that's good. I don't know who did the cinematography for the film. Not Roger Deakins, I could tell that much, but it still looked pretty great. Like, basically, every aspect of this movie, it worked for the movie. They did some really great contrast work with the colors to specify certain things within the film that really only come to light after the big third act reveal, but you're not gonna hear about it here. And of course, Mr. Villeneuve directed the film just as well as he directed the last three films of his that I've seen, and I still haven't seen Incendie, but I plan to see that at some point in my life. Definitely, I really want to. And I guess what I'm saying is his direction was pretty much perfect. Above all that jazz, though, this film works. It really, really well. It makes us care not just about what happens to humanity in the wake of the biggest event in the history of time, but we care about Louise and we want to see where she ends up. The true brilliance in the writing here, though, is that the film takes all of these ingredients and melds them with a very high concept idea. And two amazing things happen here is one, none of these ingredients get lost, and two, this really high concept, cool idea never gets compromised, and its vision never gets lost in any of the details. So that's quite a feat. Not only that, but the film cleverly leaves clues all throughout, and once it all comes together in the final act, it just makes you go like, holy shit. And not only that, but the film does so without a single ream of exposition, instead opting for a visual approach. And that type of stuff is my absolute jam. In case you couldn't tell, this film very much impressed me. It's got it all. It's got a love story, you got the familial connections, you got the semi-accurate science stuff, you got the great performances, you got the big actors, you got the original character and ship designs, you got the brilliantly developed complete characters and all the you got all of it. You get it all. You got it all. The movie's got it all. All this stuff basically just created a perfect movie-going cocktail for me. I wouldn't say this film's for absolutely everybody, but I think it could be. I think if you're open to it, it's definitely accessible. That's a good word for it, accessible. So I give Arrival a 5 out of 5. What a surprise. Anyway, thanks for watching. It's been Roy on Celluloid. So take care. Thanks. It's been a while. I haven't been around, but I'm getting back in the game.